Here are 10 big features coming to iPadOS 18. From being able to whisk away ads on any website, calculate numbers and currency in any application, record voice memos and get transcriptions in the Notes app, and powerful tools in the Files app for formatting drives. And we'll get to the customization options like you've seen on the iPhone, but I bet there's a few features you haven't seen yet. But you can let me know in the comments. The first couple new features are in the Files app. Before, when you would plug in a USB flash drive, you would see it pop up here in the left-hand column, and you would have the option to erase it. You see that Samsung drive just appeared, you can tap and hold and erase. That was available in the last version. But what's new is, now when you tap erase, you actually have the options to format it, either in APFS, which was the default option before, or XFAT and MS-DOS. Maybe you need to plug this into a TV for a video loop, and now you can format it in XFAT version right here from your iPad. In addition to formatting drives, there's now an option to keep files downloaded locally on device. So here are some of the thumbnails for my videos, and when you tap and hold, you were able to download them previously, but now you'll see a new option called Keep Downloaded. So not only can you download a file by clicking the cloud icon like before, but now you can tap and hold on a file that's been downloaded and choose Keep Downloaded. Now, iCloud Drive is not going to remove it from your device, even when it's trying to free up space. And what's cool is you can do this for multiple files, and if you've never seen this before, you can quick select things in a list on iPad or iPhone just by dragging with two fingers. I'll do that again just for kicks. You can do this in mail, message conversations, notes, shortcuts, and more, but just swipe with two fingers, and that selects multiple items. Then you can tap and hold and choose the Keep Downloaded option. It'll save all those files locally to device, and keep them there no matter what. And just a little bonus tip, this isn't new in iPadOS 18, but if you tap and hold on a file, there's actually a quick action menu down here, and this gives you an option to actually convert the image into something like a PNG or JPEG. You can remove the background from an image, create a PDF, rotate it, or markup, all right here from this little contextual menu. And if you go to convert, you can choose JPEG, PNG, or HEIF formats, all right here in the Files app. Number three, this is on iPhone and iPad coming with iOS 18, but hide distracting items is a new feature. Where you're on a website, maybe you see some ads or newsletter pop-ups, you can actually tap a symbol here, and you'll see an option for hide distracting items. When you tap that option here in Safari, then you can actually tap on an ad, a newsletter sign-up, or any of those superfluous things you see around a website, and actually hide it from view. I can tap this ad and hide it. And now I can have a clean reading experience, or maybe because I want to take a screenshot without the ads around it, now I can do it right here in Safari. I can hit done, and for this reading session, those ads won't come back. Now, if you refresh the page or go back to visit the website, they do come back and you'll need to hide them again. But this is especially helpful on pretty egregious websites where there's literally pop-ups covering everything. I cannot see any part of the content. Well, I can go to Hide Distracting Items, and let me tap this newsletter sign up and hide that. This Google login, I can hide that as well. And then if I hit done, now I can actually see the content without having all that stuff on top. Number four, another Safari feature is Listen to Page. If I tap this icon one more time, here at the bottom, you actually see the Show Reader option, which will just show you the plain text and images, and there's a new Listen to Page. If I tap that,
Apple today announced plans to hold its annual iPhone-centric event on Monday, September 9th.
And now you can listen to a full article just by tapping the symbol in the address bar. I can also change the speed, go up to 2x, and skip forward and backwards using these play controls right here. Which, by the way, if you enjoy listening to articles here in Safari, I highly recommend the Headway app. Headway sponsored this video, and I've been using them for several weeks now, and I love it because you actually get 15-minute summaries of the best nonfiction books available as both text and audio performed by professional voice actors. And they have a great app both for iPhone and iPad, and you can start listening to the short summary of the book right here. They bring out key points and quotes just like this, and I love this little remember feature, so if there's a point you want to commit to memory or something that really stood out, just tap remember, and that'll get saved in your profile. Or skip around the summary by tapping this icon, and you can see the main points here, and jump to that part in the summary. I now get personalized recommendations here on the home screen, or I can jump into a category. Your progress also syncs across your devices. Here's Headway on my iPhone. You can see the progress of the book right here, and jump back into it to either read or listen to that summary. Then all those things you marked to remember, I can go over to my library tab. Then under the repetition segment, I can see all the things I've saved. Repeat some of the cards that stood out to me the most from the summaries I heard and read. Scroll through, That was another book I recently did, which I really enjoyed. Then you can share these thoughts either on social media, share it with a friend, all right here in the Headway app. Then you can gamify your Headway experience with streaks to keep learning further in fun and easy ways. But this is a great way. I love getting to all these nonfiction books I've heard about, but just haven't had the time to read all the way through. So you can actually get a 7-day free trial of Headway by going to the link beard.fm/headway. Get bite-sized 15-minute summaries, listen to it like a podcast from the Headway app on your iPhone or your iPad, and again, I think you'll love it. Try it again for free, 7-day trial, link is down in the description, beard.fm/headway. Now, back to iPadOS 18. So not only can you listen to articles here in Safari, but another feature coming to iOS and iPadOS 18 are article summaries. Not only can you listen to Page, but you'll actually see a summary of this article right here in the little drop-down menu. If I tap Show Reader, I go into reader mode, but I'll also see a summary right here, which I can expand and just read that paragraph, and even a table of contents that talks about the different parts of the article. Then I can tap one of those parts and it will actually jump down to it. Now, these summaries are actually different than Apple Intelligence summaries. These have to be curated by Apple, so they're only available on specific websites. Once Apple Intelligence comes out later this year, then you'll be able to summarize any web page, no matter what, using Apple Intelligence. But for now, certain websites will allow this summary. But if you are on a web page and you happen to see the little star icon up here, tap that symbol for the summary, or just tap and hold and you'll jump right into reader mode. Then you can see the summary, table of contents, all right here. Plus it pulls out pertinent information even like actresses and the TV show. And you can tap there to jump to it in Apple TV. Another feature, in addition to summaries, is called Highlights. This is going to be on iPhone, Mac, and iPad as well. But when you see that little star icon when that symbol shows, tap it if you're on a website like a hotel, a restaurant, and maybe the address isn't readily visible. Well, this drop-down menu is now going to have that pertinent information right here available to you. So hours, the location on the maps, and then you can just tap it and be brought to that location in the Maps app. By the way, that hide distracting items also works for like these videos that autoplay and then stay in the corner. You can just tap it and make it go away. Love that feature. And number 7, one of the big announcements was Calculator on the iPad. Yes, there is now a dedicated calculator app. You can go from scientific to basic and also use the new Math Notes feature, which you've probably seen demoed. Write with your finger or Apple Pencil, simple equations, even variables, and you can get the answer right here. But what you might not know is Math Notes actually works across the operating system. So I can even go into the Bare Notes app here on my iPad where I keep all my notes. And we were measuring a wall for some sound treatment. So maybe the measurements were 120 inches and I need to add another part of the wall, another 45 inches. Well, now all I have to do is type an equal sign here in Bare and it's actually going to calculate that automatically. That was that Math Notes feature that's now built across the operating system. I can even be here in my text messages, do the same kind of equation. And as soon as I type the equal sign, it's going to appear right here before I send the message. This also works for currency conversions. Maybe I'm texting someone and I know I need to convert the amount, but I'm not sure what it is. I'll type an amount with a US dollar sign, hit the equal symbol, and you can see immediately it converts it to euros. I can also go the other way. I'll use the pound currency symbol, then equals, and it's going to convert it back to USD. And you can do that anywhere you can type text here on iPad or your iPhone. Number 8, you now get full transcriptions when you record voice memos, either in the Voice Memos app or the Stock Notes app. I'm going to start recording a voice memo right here on my iPad, and you'll see the little transcription symbol lives up here. If I tap that, it's actually going to transcribe this live as I'm talking, plus it's still recording the audio. This is amazing if you're in a class or a lecture, maybe a conference, and you want to record what you're hearing, but also get a full transcription. This is extremely powerful. And once you're done recording, I can tap done here. You have access to both the text and the audio. Then I can jump in here to the text, select it, copy and paste it elsewhere, or share it if you have one of my many shortcuts that integrate with ChatGPT. Apple Intelligence can also take this text and summarize it or give you bullet points. But if you want to see some of my shortcuts with ChatGPT built in that can really take advantage of these transcripts, check out this video above or down in the description. And also, I have an entire playlist on shortcuts. You should check those out too. You can also record those voice memos directly here in the Notes app and tap it to get the full transcription right here. All right, number 9, you've seen this on the iPhone, but you also get a fully customizable control center here on the iPad. Not only do you get multiple pages like controls that you specify, you can go to the smart home controls, now playing screen, and even add additional custom pages, you can add whatever you would like here in the Control Center. Tap and hold, tap Add a Control. Now you have all these options available to you. You can add things like screen mirroring, and now that control is here, and you can even resize them if you'd like to make them larger. Bigger touch targets, or like what I've done here is increase the Now Playing widget, so rather than being small or a square, I can have that kind of horizontal widget. Plus, not only can you add custom controls, but you can run shortcuts right here from Control Center. Here you can see Add a Shortcut, choose one, or add a bunch of them right here in Control Center. And you can also specify specific smart home devices to control rather than just being recommended smart home devices. This way they're not changing throughout the day. You can specify what scenes and devices you have here. And of course, number 10, you've already seen home screen customization everywhere. Well, it's also here on the iPad. Just tap Edit once you go into Juggle mode and then Customize. And you can tint your icons if you would like. Change that color here. Change the saturation of that color using the bottom slider. You can also go into dark mode for icons, light mode, and even do large icons, which here on the iPad mini, they look pretty large. And you can also pull a color from the wallpaper. This wallpaper is from Basic Apple Guy. You can use the color picker, drag it around, choose a color, then all your icons will be tinted to match it. Plus, you can put icons anywhere you'd like on the home screen. It does not have to be in that top down, left to right order anymore. And a really cool feature is you can actually resize widgets right here without having to remove, add, or edit them. Just tap and hold on these little handles and make the widget a different size. Which, speaking of which, this is the Apple Podcast widget. I do prefer the podcast widget over like Overcast, Pocket Cast, and even Castro. But wherever you listen to podcasts, definitely check out Primary Technology, my show with Jason Aten. Comes out every Thursday, both here on YouTube, and you can listen wherever you get your podcasts. And don't forget, not only can you add shortcuts in the Control Center, but on the lock screen of your iPad, you can also have all the custom icons and controls you would put in Control Center, and that includes shortcuts. If I tap and hold on the lock screen here and hit Customize, then I can go back in and add whatever widgets I would like. Here I have a full calendar. You can put a ChatGPT control right here on the lock screen. And of course, add shortcuts right here, program it to whatever you'd like, and you can run them right here from the lock screen. Those are 10 big features coming to iPad and many coming to iPhone as well. But if you'd like to go even more in depth, like the top features coming to messages like RCS, sending later, and more reactions, check out this video right here where I go through just the updates coming to messages in iOS 18. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel and hit that like button because the iPhone 16 event is September 9th this year, just a couple weeks away from when I'm recording this video. And I'm going to cover all the news and review it right here on the channel. And if you want to learn more about Apple Intelligence and what that will be capable of, I have an entire video on that right up here. Thanks for watching. I'll catch you next time.